please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Good time to invite our next guest, Sunil Singhania, CFA and founder of Abakkus Asset Manager, is with us from the sidelines of the CFA Society India's third wealth management conference. Sunil, good morning. A lot of wealth being generated in equities to manage. What is this conference about, and your own thoughts?
So I think, you know, in line with the CFA's global, you know, thought process about spreading literacy across financial markets, I think obviously we started with the India Investment Conference some 7-8 years back, and for the last 3 years we have been organizing this wealth management conference. Because finally in India, you know, managing wealth is becoming more professional. There are a lot of family offices. People are looking not only at real estate and gold and jewelry, but also other facets of you know, wealth management, whether it be equities, fixed income, and structured products. So I think all in all, it promises to be a very interesting session. And we have an excellent lineup of speakers right from morning till the end of the day. So hopefully the 500 plus participants who have registered and are attending we'll have something useful to take home.
Yeah. Sunil, hi, good morning. Well, we're waiting to hear what the takeaways from that conference are. But what has the sentiment been so far with respect to domestic retail money? A couple of months back, we were discussing how the entire equity cult has, you know, changed. I mean, there's so much SIP money coming in. You think that trend continues now? And do you see a lot more coming into the domestic retail fraternity?
So, you know, Sonia, for the last month and a half, I've been traveling across the country, meeting investors for my new fund, the Abakkus Growth Fund. Though I would honestly say that my focus has been on the HNI category. One thing I can say is that this 1.5 month has been a revelation for me. I think the kind of wealth which is there in India is like very, very surprising. And another aspect of it is that, you know, the markets are at an all-time high, but maybe the exposure to equity is still very, very small. In fact, there are more people willing to or waiting for the markets to correct to invest rather than the other way around. So I think, you know, the clear move from physical assets to financial assets and, you know, investors looking at that is very, very visible. And I think as we move ahead, that is only going to get stronger and stronger. So as far as flows are concerned, I've only got more confident in the last 1.5 months than I was earlier.
Good morning, Sunil. You may have a litany of great speakers at the CFA event, but we also have a litany of good speakers here. We have Sunil Singhania with us. Well, you know, I wanted to know if really fund management is...
You're very kind to me.
If fund management is that money making a business as it was, you know, there are lots of SEBI rules coming in and looks like more will follow. Now, do you think that, you know, people may go the ETF way? So many funds have gotten listed. And interestingly, you know, some of them are even, some of their own employees are selling off from taking profit in those funds. So is fund management listed stocks a great idea?
See, I think, you know, you have to understand that investments are to create wealth. And at some point of time, every investor has a right to, you know, diversify out of the core wealth they have created over so much of hard work. And people have different aspirations in life also. You know, someone would be wanting to buy a new house and so on and so forth. So I don't read too much into this day-to-day analysis of someone selling 1 crore, 2 crores worth of stock. And I think we should get away from that. Regarding your other question, you know, very clearly, as I mentioned earlier, there is this move towards moving away from physical savings to financial savings. And we have only started off. I would say, you know, the total fund management slash wealth management industry in India is not even $400 billion. For an economy size of $2.5 trillion, which is slated to go to $6 and $7 trillion over the next 10 years. So I think this industry is only going to grow. Yes, you know, there would be challenges in terms of the fee structure. Particularly, my view is that the large cap funds would find it very tough to outperform the benchmark, and therefore the fee structure there definitely would compress. But having said that, I think the amount of assets which can come into this industry can surprise for a long, long time. And we have seen that in other parts of the world. So why would it not happen in India? So I don't want to comment on individual stocks or the valuation at this point of time. But I would say that asset management slash wealth management slash life insurance companies, I would they would have a great future in India.
Okay. So, Sunil, in that case, the kind of inflows that we saw last year, this year, of course, there's been a bit of a doubt on whether after seeing the brutal correction in mid-caps, the first time retail investors would get jittery. You reckon incrementally we can keep on churning these kind of numbers in domestic flows? And, you know, of course, you know, you answered that in part to Sonia's question, but could that lead to further re-rating of our market?
So, two, three aspects to it. One is, you know, you mentioned a very strong adjective, brutal. And to some aspect, it might be right if you take a point-to-point, you know, correction. Say, in the last 6 months, yes, mid-caps and small-caps have fallen a lot. But if you take a one-year scenario, I think a lot of good small-cap funds are returning as much as the Nifty and much better than the large-cap funds. So it would be wrong to say that over a one-year period, they have underperformed dramatically. Second is, you know, my view is that India has grown because of entrepreneurship. And that should continue as we move forward. There are so many new sectors coming up, new entrepreneurs coming up. You know, risk capital through venture funds, through private equity funds is available much more easier than it was earlier. And I would say that in a growing economy like India, which is slated to grow from 2.5 to 7, as I mentioned earlier, there would be a lot of opportunities for mid and small caps even as we move forward. In terms of flows, again, you know, we look at the historic flows, and therefore a $2 billion flow a month looks very large. But again, look at India's savings. You know, we save $600 billion. And even if you take $2 billion a month, it's like 4% of our savings coming into equities every year. So I think it's just just, I would say, the start of a cycle. At the same time, my view is that only flows will never lead to markets sustaining at levels beyond a fair valuation for a long, long period of time. You know, they can sustain for a short period of time because of flows, but ultimately fundamentals have to catch up. And my view here would be that, yes, because of the domestic flows, the markets have become much more stable. We are not as dependent on foreign flows as we was earlier, which is good for the Indian markets and the economy. But ultimately, unless the profit growth you know, inches up, flows only are not going to help over a period of time. And I think that is where our view is, that profit growth has finally started to be seen, particularly in the June quarters. As we move forward, you know, September quarters promises to be another exciting quarter because of the base effect. As last year, July to September had a big impact. It was the first quarter post-GST. And some of the larger corporate banks which were declaring losses should also hopefully turn around as we move forward. So I think we are more positive on the market because of an impending profit growth rather than only flows. I think flows would only make the markets much more stable and less volatile.
Okay, I'm glad you said the word banks, because, you know, it's a very interesting period in the times of private sector banks. There's so many leadership changes. I mean, this morning we hear about Rana Kapoor's appointment. Of course, it has no timeline, the reappointment, that is. But how do you approach it as an investor? Do you use these periods of uncertainties as a buying opportunity? Because, you know, as someone said earlier, I mean, no individual is bigger than the organization, so things will definitely move on. Would you concur with that view?
I think an organization outlasts everyone, you know. So I would not like to, again, comment on individual banks, but I would say that we have seen in so many institutions that, you know, an institution which is well created in terms of procedures and, you know, a sort of a team would eventually, you know, obviously come out of it. Leaders do make a difference, but ultimately the organization sustains. In terms of our view on the banking sector, again, you know, corporate banks look exciting. We have already seen a big outperformance over the last couple of months by corporate banks over their retail counterparts. And then if you look at the scenario going forward, you know, we had metals, which were a big part of NPAs for these corporate banks, almost getting resolved because there is more than enough appetite for these kind of companies when they come out on the auction block by NCLT. We have seen some large deals on the roadside, on the cement side. And now, over the last two, 3 days, there is a good news flow emerging where one power asset, there is competing bids by two large companies. So hopefully, in the next two, 3 months, we might also have some positive news flow coming out from stressed power sector. Mm-hmm. So incremental news flow for corporate banks look to be positive, and I think that is the space which might outperform over the next couple of years.
See, the same two guys are competing for two power projects. Bhushan Power as well is facing competition now, of course, Prayagraj. Sunil, we are given to understand that you have to speak over there at 10 o'clock, so we are being warned that we shouldn't be keeping you too long.